there's an old adage, and everybody's just about heard it by now. A lot of people have anyway, and that is what? If you want to hide something,
black
person, put it in a book.
If you want
to hide money or anything, put it in a book. That black person will not pick up that book. You leave something on the mail, the people that deliver mail, they put mail on your doorstep, and you run up to it, and the word has gone out. If you're black, you run up and look at that package, and it says books. That black person is going to say, oh, no, I am not risking going to jail, walking off with no book of any kind that was ever printed. No. Give me some electronic gear or something like that. So, could be something to that.
Yes.
And the white supremacists always want black people to have this mindset about a book. That's why in what you call plantation slavery days, they did what? They said, you can't read a book. In fact, if the master of the house saw one of his slaves looking at some of his books, when the slave didn't know that the master would catch him looking at the books, he would give him a good whipping, or her. Reading can be laborious. That's why I tried to write the code book in such a way that I tell people in the book itself, in the introductory remarks, just pick up the book and turn to any page. That's how you start. That's the best way to do it, rather than try to find time to sit down and go through the whole book. In this day and time, particularly in the Northwestern Hemisphere, that's not going to work very well for most people anyway. So just pick up the book and sample something. Just turn to any page and read what's on that page and see if you get something out of it. And just do that for quite a period of time. Sometimes I read books like that. Particularly, I have a favorite way of reading a number of books, books of quotes, nothing but quotes. I kind of have a tendency to have an appeal, rather. I gravitate toward books that have quotes in them, nothing but quotes from different people. And just turn to any page and pick up something and think about what I just read, just one sentence or one paragraph, and think about it. And you get a lot out of that. I find that works for a lot of people.
Yes, sir.
In fact, I have a quote section in the basic book, the 2016 edition, in the back of the book, of nothing but my quotes. The sound bite, you might call them, in this day and time. So reading is laborious for most time. People are busy. They just don't have time to read. Television helps. A lot of people say they don't look at television. I look at a lot of television because you're supposed to keep up on what people are doing even if you don't agree with it. You're in the world. You're in this prison yard. Things happen in the prison yard. You want to be aware of things that are going on around you. If you can't isolate yourself from it. There's no way to hide. There's no place to go. A prison is a prison. And the white supremacists always know where you are, and
what
they pretty well know what you're doing. Yeah.